In this workbook, you can select a number from this drop-down list, and that number of rows appears below. And then from each blue cell, you can select a color, and that color appears as a sample in the adjacent cell. This doesn't require any macros. It's done with conditional formatting and data validation, and I'm going to show you how you can set it up. So here's another workbook, and I've just set up the headings, and then on another sheet, I've got lists. So I've got a list of 8 numbers, and I'm using 3 colors for this demo. We're going to create named ranges based on these lists. So I will select all the numbers, click in the name box, and type a one-word name, and I'll call this num list. Press enter. So that range is named, and then I'll call this color list. So again, click in the name box, color list, press enter. So now we have 2 names, and you can see them if you click the arrow in that name box. Going back to this demo sheet, this is where we're going to set up those lists. And in this box, we're going to use data validation to create a drop down with those numbers. So on the ribbon, I'll go to the data tab, click data validation, and I want a list in that cell. So I'll select list. And in the source box, I have to tell it which list to use. And the quickest way to get the list is to press the F3 key. And that opens up paste name. I want the number list called numList. Click OK. Click OK. And now we have a drop-down list in that cell. To make it apparent that you should do something in that cell, I'm going to color the cell with blue fill color. Just a light blue color here. We're going to let people select up to 8 colors. So I'm going to select 8 cells here. And up in the name box, you can see the number of rows that I have selected. So right now I've got 8 rows by 1 column. And for those cells, I'm going to use data validation again. So data validation. Again, we'll allow a list. And click in the source box, press F3, and this time we want the color list, so I'll select that, click OK, and click OK. If I click on this cell, you can see that it has the 3 colors available in the drop-down. I'm going to just type the numbers 1 through 8 here, so I'll start with 1 and 2, and then select those and drag down until I can see that 8 is going to be the last number. So we have the options available. What I want to happen is when someone selects a number of options, those numbers appear over here with a box beside them with blue fill color and a border so people know they should select a color. When the sheet is first opened, if they haven't selected a number of options, I want nothing to appear down here. And for these numbers to disappear, I'm just going to make them a white font. So I'll go to the Home tab, and for the font color, I'll pick white. And the fill color, I'll also make that white. Next, I'll use conditional formatting in these cells so that they get a border and the font changes to black whenever the number here is less than or equal to this number. So if you select 4, numbers 1 through 4 should appear. So on the Home tab, click Conditional Formatting, New Rule. We're going to create a formula, so click Use a Formula. And in this box, I'm going to type my formula. So start with an equal sign. I'll check the worksheet to see which is the active cell. And I can see that B5 has its name in the name box, and it's white where the others are gray. So that's the active cell. And I want to compare the active cell to this number where we selected the number of options. So equals B5 is less than or equal to. And then I'll click on C2 and it gets dollar signs. It's an absolute reference. I want every cell to compare itself with that cell. But I want B5 in this case, but C5 here and so on. So this doesn't get dollar signs, and this does. So if it's less than or equal to that, I'm going to format it, and it should get a border, an outline border, and the font. Instead of automatic, I'll make it black, and then click OK. Click OK, and now we can see those cells are working. If I change this to 3, we go down to 3 cells visible here. Next, we're going to do conditional formatting on this color column. So I'll select the 8 cells here. And I'm going to, again, go to the Home tab, Conditional Formatting, New Rule. So for these cells, again, we're going to use a formula. And this time we can see that C5 is the active cell. And in this column, we're going to check and see if the number to the left is less than or equal to the number in cell C2. So equals B5 is less than or equal to C2. So it's really the same formula that we used in the option column. But in this case, we're not checking the cell that we're in, we're checking the cell to the left. We want to see if you're in this color cell, what option number is over here, and is it less than the number of options we have selected. Again, we'll click Format, and we want a border, an outline border. And this time we don't want to change the font, we're going to change the fill. And I'll use a light blue, and click OK, and OK. So now we've got 3 options selected, so 3 of these cells are ready for you to enter some data. I can click here and select yellow. So I'll just fill in the other 2 here just so we can see all 3 colors that we're going to be using. And then we're going to fill in conditional formatting in this sample column. I'm going to select the 8 cells. And in this cell, we want it to show the selected color. I'll go up to the Home tab, Conditional Formatting, New Rule. We'll use a formula. And in this cell, I'm going to check to see if red was selected. So equals, and we're going to check cell C5 and see if it's equal to red. And I'll put that in double quotes. So equals, double quote, red. And it doesn't matter if it's upper or lower case. And for that, I'm going to click Format. We'll put a border, outline, and the fill for this should be red. So I'll click OK. And we now have our first rule. I'll click OK again. And that's working there. I'm going back and creating a rule for yellow. Conditional formatting, new rule, formula. And in here, we're going to check and see if cell C5 is equal to yellow, because D5 is still our active cell, so equals C5 equals yellow. And click Format, choose the yellow fill color, and put on a border. Click OK, and OK. We can see our yellow is working, and the final one will be blue. Conditional formatting, new rule, formula, equals C5 equals blue. Click Format, put on an outline border, and choose a fill color that's blue. Click OK, and OK. So now we can see that each of these works. If I change this to red, it shows red here. I'm going to change the number of options and show a couple more. So if I change this to 5, 2 more of these color cells have turned blue. I can choose yellow, and it fills in that with yellow. Blue here fills that in with blue. So with conditional formatting and data validation, we can make numbers appear, we can make cells change color, and we can create drop-down lists so you can select items. For more Excel tips and tutorials, and to download the sample file for this video, please visit my Contextures website at www.contextures.com.